Hey everyone, it's JC from Okotoko Labs, and today we're going to be modeling the Plasticity Penguin. Let's jump in.
Start by clicking on this cube and pressing X to delete it. Now let's go to the right side by clicking on the right side of the view cube. Let's zoom out a little bit. Next, let's create a sphere by going to the toolbar down here and clicking once and then hovering outwards until you see 10 units in the center of the sphere. Left click once, and now press Shift D to duplicate and move it up the Z axis around 6.3 units. Next, press S twice and shrink it around 0.6 units. Right click to accept, and let's select both of them. Now press Q twice, and this will create a union boolean where both objects are now merged. Right click to accept, and then press 2 so we can select this edge here. Let's zoom in a little bit. And now with that handle, you can pull it outwards and you'll create a fillet. Let's keep going until you hit around 27. Right click for that. Next, create a new sphere and place it near the top of the head. It should measure around 1.25 units. Press B to create a new body. Otherwise, it'll create a boolean, and right-click to accept that. Next, press S and scale it down the Z-axis around 0.6 units. Now press R, and we're going to rotate it on the X-axis around 20 units. Now let's go to perspective view and press S and scale it on the X-axis around 0.6. Now we need to have it on the other side as well, so press Alt-X and then press on this red axis, and you'll see it's on both sides now. Right click, and now let's go to the front view by clicking on the front side of the view cube, and let's create the beak. So zoom into the top here and find an empty area, and go to your toolbar and click down and make sure you select Control Point Curve. Now let's create a C shape by clicking once, two times, three here, four, and five, and right click. Next, go down to this third button down here where it says Revolve. Click that once, and click at the bottom, and now at the top, and right click. So now you have a revolved object here, which will be the beak. But it's looking a little bit small, so press S, and let's scale it in the Y axis about 2 units. Next, go to your right side view, and let's press G twice and place it on the head. Left click once and right click to accept and zoom out so we can see it all together. Now press 2 so we can select this curve on the top and then press H to hide it. Next, we're missing the belly region. So go to your side view and let's create another one of those control point curves. And again, we're gonna use 5 points to define the belly. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and right click. Next, press C and select the main body. Right click to accept, and now you've performed a cut using that curve. Select that curve and H to hide that. Now, drag a rectangle and select 2 of these curves, and drag this handle outwards to create a fillet. And select chordal so you have a uniform radius around that fillet, and press OK. Now let's apply some materials, but before we do that, let's turn off edges by right-clicking on the toggle render mode and clicking on show edges. Next, let's turn off this grid over here. And make sure you're in solid mode by pressing 4. Now click on toggle render mode and select the main body. Press M and let's turn this to a dark gray. Then let's turn roughness to 0.6. and press OK. Now let's select the belly, press M, and turn the roughness to 0.5, and press OK. Next, let's do the eyes, so select one, and shift select the other, and then press M, and change the color to almost black. Let's increase the roughness to 0.25, and press OK on that. And finally, select the beak, press M, and change it to a red-orange. and increase the roughness to around 0.6. And now you're the proud owner of a Plasticity penguin. Thanks for watching. And if you're interested in diving deeper into Plasticity, check out my free minicam course linked below. Also, I'd love to hear your thoughts, so leave a comment, and I'll see you next time.